Reverend Father, give the blessing. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For peace from on high, for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For peace in the whole world, for the stability of the holy churches of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy church and for all who enter with faith, reverence, and fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. For our holy Father Francis, Pope of Rome, let us pray to the Lord. For our most reverend Metropolitan William, for our God-loving Bishop Milan, for the venerable Presbyter and the Diacon in Christ and all clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord. For our government and for all in the service of our country, let us pray to the Lord. For this city, for every city, community, and for the faithful living in them, let us pray to the Lord. For favorable weather, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For those who travel by sea, air, and land, for the sick, the suffering, the captive, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. That we be delivered from all affliction, wrath, and need, let us pray to the Lord. Protect us, save us, have mercy on us, and preserve us, O God, by your grace. Commemorating our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another, and our whole life to Christ our God.
O Lord our God, mighty beyond description, glorious above understanding, merciful without limits, loving us all beyond expression, look with compassion on us and this holy church, O Master, and show us in those who pray with us riches your tender mercy. For to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, is your glory, honor, worship, now and ever, and forever.
Amen.
For you are holy, O God, and we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever.
And forever.
Peace be to all.
Wisdom be attentive.
The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament proclaims his handiwork.
Wisdom.
A reading from the book of Hebrews.
Let's be attentive.
Brethren, remember your leaders who spoke the word of God to you. Consider how their lives ended and imitate their faith. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Do not be carried away by all kinds of strange teaching. It is good to have our hearts strengthened by the grace of God, and not by foods which are useless to those who take them as a standard for living. We have an altar from which those who serve the tabernacle have no right to eat. The bodies of the animals whose blood is brought into the sanctuary by the high priest as a sin offering are burned outside the camp. Therefore, Jesus died outside the gate to sanctify the people by his own blood. Let us go to him outside the camp, bearing the insults which he bore. For here we have no lasting city. We are seeking one which is to come. Through him let us continually offer God a sacrifice of praise, that is, the fruit of lips which acknowledge his name. Do not neglect good deeds and generosity. God is pleased by sacrifices of that kind.
Peace be to you, reader.
Wisdom be attentive.
Amen. The heavens declare your wonders, O Lord, and your truth in the assembly of the holy. God is glorified in the council of the holy, great and awesome above all who surround him.
Reverend Father, bless the proclaimer of the Gospel of the Holy Apostle and Evangelist Matthew.
May God, through the praise of the Holy, Glorious, Illustrious Apostle, Evangelist Matthew, grant that you proclaim the word with great power for the fulfillment of the Gospel of his beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Wisdom, let us stand, listen to the Holy Gospel. Peace be to all.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Oh, let us be attentive.
The Lord said to his disciples, "You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden. Men do not light a lamp and then put it under a bushel basket. They set it on a stand where it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, your light must shine before men so that they may see goodness in your acts and give praise to your heavenly Father. Do not think that I have come to abolish the law and the prophets. I have come not to abolish them, but to fulfill them. Of this much I assure you, until heaven and earth pass away, not the smallest letter of the law, not the smallest part of a letter, shall be done away with until it all comes true. That is why whoever breaks the least significant of these commands and teaches others to do so shall be called least in the kingdom of God. Whoever fulfills and teaches these commands shall be great in the kingdom of God." Glory to Jesus Christ. When I was still in the seminary, I had the opportunity to meet Archbishop Philip. Some of you might know him because he served the liturgy at our parish many years ago. I met him, and it was a special experience because it has completely impacted my life in a great way. I met him at a mini clergy retreat where he was a guest speaker and then did a Q&A afterwards. Now, the questions that the clergy asked were good and necessary for everybody to hear. But for me, there was something missing, something more personal. Yes, the clergy asked the questions how to fix the church as a whole, but no one asked, how can I, and what can I do to fix my parish, rather than look at the whole picture? So after the whole Hierarchs priest asked their questions, I raised my hand and I asked, "Vladyko, what would your advice be to all other seminarians, and myself included, who are preparing to enter the Holy Priesthood?" He leaned forward, he looked at me, smiled, and he said, Go to your cave and pray. His answer seems simple at first, but after many years, it's not as simple as it seems. Yes, we need to retrieve and go to our prayer corner and pray multiple times a day, but that is just the half of it. That's the easier part of it. The other half is more difficult part. It is the part where we have to renounce the world and our desires and find time for God. Today's feast, there are three hierarchs, and they show us how to live a Christian life. For example, St. Basil the Great, he abandoned his promising career, dedicated to look for a spiritual father, admired the ascetic feats and virtues of monks, gathered everything good from these monks, and then looked for a remote and quiet place where he could apply all the good and virtuous feats that he had gathered from these monks. And all of this was done with an intensive prayer before he became bishop. St. Gregory, he was a co-struggler with St. Basil. He fled from the worldly secular knowledge, and his heart was set on a living God. He freed his intellect from every worldly attachment and yearned for silence in the world, which then he received, and he received with it peace and silence in the world before he became a bishop. St. John did not want to waste his time with the worldly vanities and turned to study of the saints and life of the saints at a very young age, half of my age. Then he gave up all contact with the world and withdrew to his family house, where he lived in severe ascesis, where he devoted himself zealously to fasting, keeping vigils, keeping prayer without allowing himself to be distracted. God or nothing else. He remained constantly with God in silence and ready to repel any surges of sin before he became a bishop. All three saints that we celebrate today had many things in common, but there was one main one, and that is they renounced the world. They withdrew into their cave, and they had their sight focused on God. They went to their cave because they could become the light of the world, as the gospel tells us today. It might seem difficult to us. Their life is not possible in today's age. It is. It is more than possible. You just have to imitate their lives. They all had different paths to holiness, and they showed us a different ways how to reach God. Those saints had struggles that we do not have, and we have struggles that they didn't have. So we have to leave the excuse that Christian life was much easier back then, because it was not. Christian life is always difficult, because we always have to fight the world, and it takes time and effort. St. Basil, Gregory, and John fought the world by renouncing its works and withdrawing into the caves to become a living prototypes of Christian holiness through their life and even after their death. Archbishop Philip showed his deep practical knowledge of their lives of the saints. He did not say anything else because he knew that there is nothing else to practice. So let us withdraw from the world with this blessed stubbornness and go to our cave where we meet Christ one on one. And then we can become light of the world as the saints that we celebrate today. Glory to Jesus Christ. Let us all say with our whole soul and with our whole mind, let us say, O Lord, Almighty God of our fathers, we pray you hear and have mercy. Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray you hear and have mercy. Again, we pray for our Holy Father, Francis, Pope of Rome, and for our Most Reverend Metropolitan William, for our God, loving Bishop Milan, for those who serve and have served in this Holy Church, for our spiritual fathers, and for our brothers and sisters in Christ. Again, we pray for our government and for all in the service of our country. Again, we pray for the people here present who await your great and abundant mercy, for those who show us mercy, and for all Christians of the true faith.
For you are merciful, loving God, and we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. May the Lord God remember his kingdom, our Holy Father Francis Pope of Rome, our Most Reverend Metropolitan William, our God-loving Bishop Milan, the Interpriestly Diaconal Monastic Order, our government and all in the service of our country, and the ever-memorable founders and benefactors of this Holy Church. May the Lord God remember all you Christians of the true faith, always, now and ever, and forever. Робите зверата. Living brother consolabrant, pray for me consolabrant. May his presence second with all these lives. Remember his kingdom always and ever and forever. Amen.
For the precious gifts placed before us, let us pray to the Lord.
Grant his rare mercy, his only begotten Son, is me all blessed together with your all holy good and life creating spirit, now and ever and forever. Peace be to all.
Let us love one another, that with one mind we may profess. The doors in wisdom, let us be attentive. Let us stand aright, let us stand in awe, let us be attentive to offer the holy anaphora in peace.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and Father and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Oh, let us lift up our hearts. Oh, let us give thanks to the Lord. It is proper and just to sing to you, bless you, praise you, to thank you, to worship in every place your dominion, for your God, ineffable, inconceivable, invisible, incomprehensible, ever existing, ever the same, you and your only begotten Son, your Holy Spirit, you brought us out of non-existence into being, again raised us up when we had fallen, left nothing undone, until you brought us to heaven and gave us your kingdom to come. For all this we thank you, your only begotten Son, your Holy Spirit, for all that we know and that we do not know, for the manifesting and benefits bestowed on us. We also thank you for this liturgy, which you are pleased to accept from our hands, even though there stand before you thousands of archangels, tens of thousands of angels, cherubim and seraphim, six-winged, many eyes soaring out on their wings, singing, shouting, crying aloud, and sing the triumphal hymn. We also cry out with these blessed powers, loving kind Master, and say, Holy and all holy, you and your only begotten Son and your Holy Spirit. Holy and all holy, magnificent is your glory. You so loved your world that you gave your only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him should not perish but have life everlasting. He came and fulfilled the whole divine plan in our behalf on the night he was betrayed. Or rather, when he surrendered himself for the life of the world, he took bread into his holy and all pure and immaculate hands, gave thanks and blessed, sanctified, broke, and gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you, for the remission of sins. Likewise, he took the chalice after supper, saying, Drink of this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Remembering, therefore, this sin command, and all is come to pass in our behalf, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection, and the third day, the ascension into heaven, the sin to the right hand of the second coming glory, offering you your own from your own, always and everywhere. Sam Boží pomyślna. Sam Boží pomyślna. Moreover, we offer to you this spiritual and unbodily sacrifice of implore, pray, and entreat you. Send down your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts lying before us, and make this bread the precious body of Christ, and that which is in this chalice the precious body of Christ, changing them by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, those who partake of them, then bring about the spirit of vigilance, the remission of sins, the communion of your Holy Spirit, the fullness of the heavenly kingdom, and confidence in you, not judgment or condemnation. Moreover, we offer the spiritual sacrifice for those departing faith, the forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and for religious spirit brought to perfection in faith. Especially for our most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and the Virgin Mary. Among the first, O Lord, remember Holy Father Francis Pope Rome, our most reverend Metropolitan William, our God, loving Bishop Milan, preserve them for your holy churches in peace, safety, honor her for many years, as they faithfully impart the word of truth. and grant that with one voice, one heart, we may glorify and praise the most honored, magnificent name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever, and forever. May the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of you.
Now that we have commemorated all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts offering consecrated there are God who loves us all, may receive them on this holy, heavenly, and mystical altar as aroma of spiritual fragrance and send down upon us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Asking for unity in faith and for the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
And make us worthy, O Master, that we may with confidence and without condemnation dare call you Father, God of heaven and say. Наше наш Исцелитель, Святой, да будет воля Твоя, как на небе, сей земли. Хлеб наш насущный, как нас воскрешение, нас избави нас от Духа Бога. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever, and forever. Peace be to all.
Bow your heads to the Lord.
Through the grace, the mercy, loving kindness, only begotten Son, with me are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and life creating Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Let us be attentive.
Holy gifts to holy people. Posled se Isus Christos, Nika, plno Svetého Ducha. Amen. 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 Díky nám pravouči, Otče, Pánu Boha, spasil, který je kromřené, posledný chová poživočný. Amen. O Lord, I believe. Díky proč? Služení Boží. Vlastně a nezná. Tohle se rychle tě očistuje. Thank you. Save your people, O God, and bless your inheritance.
Bože, nesem da se tvoja slava nik se skrije po svojoj zemlji.
Blessed is our God, always, now and ever, and forever.
Arise, now that we have received the divine, holy, most pure, immortal, heavenly, life-creating and awesome mysteries of Christ, let us worthily thank the Lord.
For you are our sanctification, we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever, and forever. Oh, let us go forth in peace.
Let us pray to the Lord.
O Lord, blessing those who bless you and sanctifying those who trust in you, save your people and bless your inheritance. Preserve the fallen of your church, sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. Glorify them, return by your divine power, and do not forsake us who hope in you. Grant peace to the world, to your church, to the priests, to our government, and to all your people. For all generous, given ever perfect gift, is from above, coming down from the Father of lights. And we give glory, thanksgiving, worship to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Boží pomyšná. Jsem Boží pomyšná, Hospodí se Kriste, jsem Boží.
Now blessing of the Lord be upon you through his grace, loving kindness, always, now and ever, and forever. Glory to you, O Christ God, our hope. Glory to you. May Christ, our true God, have mercy on us and save us through the praise of his most pure Mother, and of the holy, glorious, last his apostles, our Holy Father, Basil the Great, our Holy Father, Gregory, our Holy Father, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, of the Holy Father, Nicholas, the patron of his church, and through the prayers of all the saints, for Christ is good. And loves us all. to servants of God, all members of this parish, and to our visitors, grant, O Lord, many years.